Welcome back. So as you can see, we are jumping right into the shower. Today is wash day and I'm gonna walk you through my all-time favorite wash day routine, start to finish. You will see the products I'm using in the shower as well as my methods and the products I use for styling. If you are not already subscribed, what are you waiting for? Go and slam that subscribe button, and while you're at it, hit that little bell right next door to make sure that you do not miss a thing. While I'm waiting for this to heat up, I just wanted to preface with, I did do a pre-food deep conditioning treatment. I don't always do those on wash day, which is why I'm not including it in this video. I'll do a demo on that later, but I wanted to keep the focus today on what I do pretty much every single wash day. So I got the deep conditioner completely rinsed out of my hair. Now I am ready for cleanser. So we're gonna use the Women to Women Naturals Gorgeous Collection Hair Cleanser. This is one of my all-time favorite cleansers. Just gonna apply directly to the scalp. Falls so well. That's fallen already. Keeping the focus on the scalp, don't really need it on our ends. If you need to get the foam to disperse a little bit more, don't be afraid to whip under the water stream. I like to massage for 2 to 3 minutes to make sure my scalp gets good and clean, and then I'll just go directly into rinse. All rinsed, ready for conditioner. So this is the Women to Women Naturals Gorgeous Collection Conditioner. First ingredient is aloe, love it.
Almost gone.
So with conditioner, I like to rake it through initially just to completely disperse the product. And then I'll do one final swipe, smooth it all back together. And then no more raking my hair from that point forward. I'm gonna do a little bit more conditioner just to smooth it all back. So a little bit more conditioner. And then this time I like to just smooth. All the strands down and back together, and then I let it sit for anywhere from 5 to 10 minutes, and then I'll rinse. Now when we're rinsing, we are going to smooth over the strands, no raking. I do not rake through my hair at any point moving forward, not in the shower and not styling. No more raking, rakes up those clumps. Just going to smooth. Rinse some of the moisture in and help that conditioner come out, but absolutely no raking. You do see me lightly going in. I'm just lifting my strands away from my scalp a bit, that the product has an easier time cutting out, but I'm not going all the way through, just focusing on the scalp. I always apply my leave-in conditioner in the shower. I'm just going to continue the program and the Gorgeous Collection leave-in. So this does come in a sprayer. I like to spray it on the palm of my hands. There's about how much. But then I'm going to massage it between my palms, and I'm going to smooth it over the canopy. On top and underneath. So I'm going to whip my hair underneath the stream of water. This helps disperse the product and it also adds a little bit more water back to your hair. Quick, give it a little shake. Give it a little shake. Then I like to pat and see if anywhere didn't get water. I'm gonna do one more this way. Let's see. And now my shower is done. So the next thing that I always do before leaving the shower is flip over my hair and scrunch out some of the excess moisture. And this also really gets the leave-in in your curls and it starts the curl formation. And it's excellent for volume. So we'll flip. Just gonna, don't have to think much about it. Just squeeze out in a scrunching motion. The last thing I do before leaving the shower is flip my hair back over and then I run my fingertips in at my scalp and lightly lift my hair away from the scalp, and this is amazing for volume. It's just in and up. And I'm gonna check back in with you when my hair is damp. I'm going to air dry until quite a bit of the moisture has come out, and then I will apply the rest of my stylers. Check back in with you then. Back! So I have air dried, no root clips, nothing. I'm probably about 50% dry. Give you a look around. I'm gonna start with the Diva Curl Frizz Free Volumizing Foam, and I'm gonna follow it with the WeDad Climate Control Gel. I'm just gonna do a couple pumps, it is almost gone. Okay. So, it's like 3.5 pumps. So I'm gonna rub in my hand. Hi, Titi! I'm gonna flip my head over and scrunch in. I don't have a set guide on how much I use. I just have a good feel for my hair. I know that probably sounds weird, but the more that you get into this, you'll find that you find those like tricks for your own hair as well. So just scrunching this in. Smooth over a little bit, but mostly scrunching. More pumps, and I'm gonna go back in at the roots. Now I'm going to add the WeDad Climate Control Gel. I don't add a lot of this, and it's fairly lightweight, which I really like. I do not like a super strong hold gel. So I'll pop that out. Same exact process. Then the same thing, just gonna add a teeny bit more to my fingertips, and then I'm gonna go in at the root, pushing away from my scalp. This really helps with volume. So you're just lifting your hair away from the root. Now I'm going to air dry for a few more minutes, gonna get like 70 to 80% of the way dry, and then I'm gonna come back and we will diffuse together. See you in a few. Back again, tell a friend, just kidding. So I am about 70, 80% of the way dry. I'm gonna go ahead and diffuse. I use Curly Co. Diffuser. It's really inexpensive. I got it off of Amazon, and I'm just using, I've had this blow dryer for like 10 years. It's a Qi blow dryer, maybe even longer than 10 years. This only has a high and low setting. I use the high speed and I just keep my finger on the cool shot, and I do diffuse upside down and I kind of go back and forth just because I found it makes calls for the best volume. back of my hair and this lower layer tend to straighten, I like to diffuse them right side up so that I'm pushing, because I found if I'm flipped over, this bottom layer is stretched over my scalp, and that's part of why it straightens out. So I try and get them upright. So sometimes these front pieces dry quicker than the rest of my hair, and they'll dry a little funky. So what I like to do, and stretched out, so I just spray them with a little bit of water. Just enough to get them re-wet, not soaked, and then I'll diffuse them again. So now that my hair is completely dry, I'm going to add root clips. Just focusing up top to allow my hair to set, and it's really, really good for volume. I am using Diva clips. You can get them at Ulta or on the Diva Curl website. You can also get similar clips that are a little bit less expensive at Sally's or on Amazon. Once it's dry, I like to get all of this like this. So, just pick a little section, loosely open, and clip it in. Looks a little funky, but it does help with volume. Again, I do have a full volume tutorial. I'll put the link in that in the description box. I'm just gonna leave them in for about 20 to 30 minutes. Most of the time I do it the length of either doing my makeup or getting ready or whatever I need to do before I go. If I'm just hanging around the house, I just leave them in until I feel like taking them out. So I am ready to take clips out. So you just gotta dig in. So next up, we are going to fluff. I am going to start with my fingertips and then I'll work my way to the comb. So here, you're just going in at the root and fluffing. And it's in, fluff, out. So you're never combing through your curls. And fluffing, I'm just shaking my root and rubbing my root at my scalp to loosen the curls up. And that is after just using my fingers. So you can see that's already a bit of volume. Alright, now we're gonna go in with a comb. I don't have a pick, so I just use this. Same thing, just gonna go in. Wash day complete, yeah! Let's have a look around. So there you have it. That is my complete wash day routine using my absolute favorite wash day lineup. Hope this helped. If you have any questions, comments, make sure and comment down below. Let me know what you're thinking. If you have not already subscribed, go slam that subscribe button and hit that bell while you're at it so you do not miss a thing. And I will be back with more soon. See ya.